In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, this morning we celebrate this Mass for the repose of the soul of Laura McClatchy. Eliminate what distracts us from God, the first of God's commandments, that he alone is God, and we shall not have other gods or idols, reaches beyond simply not offering sacrifices to pagan deities. Rather, it includes avoiding anything that we rank above God, or that prevents us from worshiping him. The importance of this commandment is seen in the way Jesus reacts against those who have made commerce, selling animals and changing money, their gods and their idols. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, author of every mercy and of all goodness, who in fasting, prayer, and almsgiving have shown us a remedy for sin, look graciously on this confession of our lowliness, that we who are bowed down by our conscience may always be lifted up by your mercy through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, God delivered all these commandments. I, the Lord, am your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery. You shall not have other gods besides me. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. For the Lord will not leave unpunished the one who takes his name in vain. Remember to keep holy the Sabbath day. Honor your father and your mother, that you may have a long life in the land which the Lord your God is giving you. You shall not kill. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, nor his male or female slave, nor his ox or ass, nor anything else that belongs to him. The word of the Lord.
Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. From the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eye. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life. They are more precious than gold, than a heap of purest gold. Sweeter also than syrup or honey from the comb. Lord, you have the words of everlasting life.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Jews demand signs, and Greeks look for wisdom. But we proclaim Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and foolishness to Gentiles. But to those who are called, Jews and Greeks alike, Christ, the power of God and the wisdom of God. For the foolishness of God is wiser than human wisdom. And the weakness of God is stronger than human strength. The word of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Since the Passover of the Jews was near, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. He found in the temple area those who sold oxen, sheep, and doves, as well as the money changers seated there. He made a whip out of cords and drove them all out of the temple area with the sheep and oxen, and spilled the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. And to those who sold doves, he said, "Take these out of here and stop making my Father's house a marketplace." His disciples recalled the words of Scripture, "Zeal for your house will consume me." At this, the Jews answered and said to him, "What sign can you show us for doing this?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews said, "This temple has been under construction for 46 years, and you will raise it up in 3 days?" But he was speaking about the temple of his body. Therefore, when he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they became to believe the scripture and the word Jesus had spoken. While he was in Jerusalem for the feast of Passover, many began to believe in his name when they saw the signs he was doing. But Jesus would not trust himself to them because he knew them all and did not need anyone to testify about human nature. He himself understood it well. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. My dear friends, this is not a happy gospel. I'm sure you, as well as everybody who hears this gospel, are a bit surprised. And never have we heard Jesus taking a whip and driving people out with anger in his voice, almost a cry of desperation. It is so, so unlike him. The one who is patient, the one who is kind and forgiving, and all these things that we expect of him. And all of a sudden, it seems that he has lost a gigantic temper. Is there any way out of this? No, there isn't. And he tells you, you might have missed it, he tells you one of the reasons why. Do you remember the little boy, Jesus, who went to the temple for the first time? He went with his mother and his father, and he was so fascinated by the temple that he stayed there, and his parents went away, and then they realized they'd lost him, and they came running back, and they found him sitting in the temple with the elders, asking and answering questions. Friends, we have nothing like the meaning of the temple in our church today. The temple was what they call the Shekinah of God, where God was most present in the world, where God lived in the Holy of Holies, where God himself was worshiped and treasured by a people who went through so much pain, through deserts and some terrible conditions, to finally get to the little place, the chosen land, the promised land, and build a temple, a beautiful temple, a temple where the Shekinah of God could blaze in glory to all the visitors that would come from far and wide to see this wonderful temple, this edifice where God was most present in the entire world. And now, grown to manhood, Jesus walks into that same temple, and he sees with his own eyes what has happened to it. He sees a shopping area. He sees people hungry with greed to make money. And to make it on what? The Shekinah of his father. And he says, "You have taken my father's house, my father's house, and you've turned it into a cattle market. How could you do that?" He's a little boy complaining in a great voice that this should never, ever have been done. And he is almost unforgivable in his anger, in his rage. And he does take up a whip, and he does drive them out. And of course, these are the people who don't deserve the whip or the driving out. No. It's those who are in charge, the high priests who allowed this to take place in their temple. They should have known better. These are only greedy little people trying to make money and don't care truly, don't care where they make it. And Jesus knows that, and that's why his answer is so strange. When the chief priests come up to Jesus and say, "How dare you do this? By what authority do you do this?" And he says, very strangely, he says, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." And he was talking about his body. He was talking about, he knew, he looked at them, and he looked at the people around him. If they could do this to God's temple, where the Shekinah of God resides, then the great fear that he had within his heart was true. One day they would take him, and he would be the sacrifice, and they would drive him up a hill, and they would crucify him on a cross. And he must have seen that as clear as the day that he was born. And how sad, he who came. But he also knew his scriptures, and he knew the Shekinah of God. He knew that God himself, his heavenly Father, was sending him to lay his life down, lay it down that he might redeem the world and to open another chapter in God's relationship with mankind, a chapter that would reach the farthest ends of the earth. For he began to understand that he was the Messiah, the chosen one of his heavenly Father, who would bring back the peace and the joy of the Shekinah of God, and it would go into the farthest ends of the earth. And so it is that the writer says this of him: while he was in Jerusalem for the feast of Passover, many began to believe in his name. And when they saw the signs that he was doing, but Jesus would not trust himself to them because he knew them all. And he did not need anyone to testify about our human nature, for he was fully divine, but also fully human. Friends, God himself becomes man at that incarnation. No one can say that he does not know what it means to be a human being, to suffer pain, to have expectations shattered, and finally, to have to face death. He knew that in his heart. And this is the cause of his great feeling. Why can they not learn to love? Why must they act this way? Why must they feel they must get ahead? Why must they hurt each other? Why must they take the great goodness, the Shekinah of God, God himself, and turn it into a rotten marketplace? The love of God drives him on. The love of God allows him to understand, just as he said when he hung upon that cross, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." My dear friends, yes, this is where we meet him today. This is where we begin to look into our own lives. because the Messiah has come to us here at this Mass. He has come to be with us. He has come to encourage us. He has come to heal us. The Shekinah of God is now Jesus Christ himself. And this is the meaning of the reading today. When you say, "Where is the Messiah?" He is in each of you and in our community, and he is here at this Holy Mass. And what are we to do, my friends? Challenge him as the people of his own time and say, "Show us signs, show us miracles, do some razzle-dazzle." No, no, my friend. He just said very simply, "I am with you today, tomorrow, and all days, even unto the consummation of the world." And what is your life? Your life is to walk with him. Your life is to talk with him. And let him influence you so that you too can walk through life with joy in your hearts, with peace in your hearts, and most of all, with a new love. Not for God, not for Jesus, but for each other. Praise be to Jesus Christ. Now let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and he became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We now bring our needs and the needs of the world before our merciful Father.
Please respond, "Lord, hear our prayer." For Pope Francis and all church leaders throughout the world, may their consistent example of following the Lord's commandments inspire the faithful to live the gospel each day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world, national, and civic leaders, may their actions be consistent with a loving and respectful attitude toward all the people they serve. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who feel they have no voice in society, may they find strength and courage in our Heavenly Father and be supported by friends and community members. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the parishioners of the St. James Community of Faith, may we take time to humbly engage in the sacrament of reconciliation, to open our hearts to God's bountiful gift of mercy, enabling us to forgive those who have hurt us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all our RCIA candidates. May they be filled with God's grace as they continue to prepare for full communion with the church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick and their caregivers, may the loving embrace of God our Father support them through times of struggle. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we lift up the names of all who have died. In a special way, we remember the repose of the soul of Laura McClatchy, for whom we offer this Eucharist. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And for the sanctity of all life, from conception until natural death, let us pray to the Lord. And for an increase in vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, religious life, and for all our seminarians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving and merciful God, hear the prayers we bring before you with sincere and trusting hearts, and answer them in accordance with your holy will. In Christ's name we pray. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with these sacrificial offerings, and grant that we who beseech pardon for our sins may take care to forgive our neighbor through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Jenny says she's having problems with the sound. Do you have your mic on?
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work, so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings, and pour out on them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we once were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love, for your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to them, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving you thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Thanks. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead, and looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim, who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart. Together with Francis our Pope and Frank our Bishop, help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom, until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints in the halls of heaven. with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint James and all the saints. And we remember especially at this Mass the repose of the soul of Laura McClatchy, and with our deceased brothers and sisters whom we humbly commend to your mercy, then freed at last from the wound of corruption and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ who lives for all eternity. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of God's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. I will now pray an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. My dear friends, Deacon Joe and I will now descend to distribute Holy Communion. I kindly ask you to listen to the instructions of our gracious volunteers. God bless you. Thank you for your kindness.
set me high on a mountain top. Save me from my distress. Save your people, O Lord. Show us the way to come home. We have been one.
Let us pray. As we receive the pledge of things yet hidden in heaven and are nourished while still on earth with the bread that comes from on high, we humbly entreat you, O Lord, that what is being brought about in us in mystery may come to true completion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My dear friends, every Friday during Lent, we have adoration from 6:30 to 7 in the church, followed by, at 7 p.m., the Stations of the Cross. If you have not had an opportunity to avail yourself of these stations, I strongly encourage you to make time in your busy lives to come on a Friday night to adore Jesus from 6:30 to 7, Stations of the Cross at 7 p.m. It is very powerful, a great Lenten devotion. And then we have Easter lilies. If you want to have an Easter lily in church for a loved one, it's $20. There's a yellow bulletin insert this weekend, or there's an offertory envelope. It's $20 per lily. And then we have the sacrament, the beautiful sacrament of reconciliation. Each Tuesday from 7 to 8 p.m., and then our usual time on Saturdays, 12:15 to 1:30. Drive-up confessions at the garage by the rectory. And then the session for the, what is it? The social justice. Open wide our hearts. Thank you. The next session is tomorrow night, March 8th, from 6:30 to 8. There's details in the bulletin. Again, it's a Zoom online. And then daylight savings time, praise God, begins next Sunday. So we spring ahead. So please try and remember Saturday night, turn your clocks ahead an hour. You don't want to miss Mass. And then, are there any people here who have a birthday during the month of March? We have one, two. All right, and for the benefit of those watching the live stream, please join me. Dear God, our Father.
Dear God, our Father.
Thank you for being with your beloved sons and daughters and bringing them into existence.
Thank you for bringing your beloved sons and daughters and bringing them into existence.
Thank you for being with them and loving them in every moment of their lives.
Thank you for being with them and loving them every moment of their lives.
And in this new year of their birth.
And in this new year of their birth.
May they know your love in new and deeper ways.
May they know your love in a new and in deeper ways.
And may they share that love most generously with others.
And may they share that love most generously with others.
As together we say, Amen. Amen. Happy birthday. God bless you. And I just want to say a great big thank you to all of our volunteers here, without which we couldn't do these outdoor masses. So thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for the blessing.
Direct, O Lord, we pray, the hearts of your faithful, and in your kindness grant your servants this grace, that abiding in the love of you and their neighbor, they may fulfill the whole of your commandments. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may the Almighty God bless you, Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace, glorifying God by your life.
Thanks be to God. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.